All I get a great kata, baby.
You and I.
Yo, now you the ginger. If you know how you the cause you drop. Shit, you not go in person. Love the way you the dance, girl. I am a major. Why you can love fire? Mommy, you be cool. Let's hop in my Maserati. Baby, hop in my Maserati. I said hop in my Maserati. Hop in my Maserati. Girl, I wanna see you go down. Say me, I love the way you bend body. Hop in my Maserati. Baby, hop in my Maserati. And I just wanna see you ride.
Somebody, somebody need somebody. My body, need your body. I'm more chipper, all of you. I'm all of you. Somebody, somebody need somebody. My body.
That I am right now. Wasn't holding you up, so there's nothing I can do to let you down. It doesn't take a trophy to make you proud. I'll never be more loved than I am right now. Ooh.
You may be seated. We've come together today to celebrate the love and devotion of Victor and Lisa. Many of you have watched their love grow from the first spark of romance to the first date to the first kiss, and now to a deep love and settled commitment to spend the rest of their lives together. We've come together to celebrate the joys of marriage, which by God's design has the potential to bring us greater intimacy, security, companionship, and strength than any other relationship in life. We've also come to witness their vows, the words of commitment which they will publicly speak between themselves, before all of you, and before God. Vows are much more than a traditional formality. Vows form a lifelong pledge, a tie that binds, a covenant of the heart that courts can nullify but cannot erase. The flowers will be gone tomorrow, the dress will be packed away, but the vows that are spoken today will last a lifetime. Who gives this woman to be married to this man?
I am my wife.
Woo! Let's pray together. Our Heavenly Father, we invite you to join us in this holy, sacred moment. We're here to witness, support, and celebrate the gift of marriage. We worship you as the Creator who gave us the gift of love, intimacy, and marriage. Come and take this couple at their word. Come and join them in the journey of a lifetime. We ask this in the name of the Lord Jesus. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Victor and Lisa, we've come today to celebrate you. We've come to witness the beginning of your new life together. We've come here to watch you declare your lifelong commitment to love and serve one another. But before we go on, I just want to share a few brief reflections on marriage. For the past couple decades, marriage has been really shrinking in popularity. Just by tying the knot today, some people would call you dreamers or idealists. Some might even call you crazy. Most young people these days don't think like their grandparents did about marriage. Getting married isn't necessarily a given, like getting older or paying your taxes. Even some of us here, as much as we say congratulations today, the question still remains, why marriage? Isn't it too messy? What if it takes away the spark? What if you fall out of love? Is a lifetime commitment really realistic? And these are good questions to ask because marriage is indeed costly. And if we're honest, our hesitation about marriage really does come down to cost. There are tangible costs to marriage, and not just because you had to buy all that cake for the wedding ceremony. Marriage means not having as much free time, maybe, not having as many options. Marriage means not always having your own way and not always having the final say. Marriage means having to say no to all kinds of opportunities, and marriage just might set you back in your career. It might limit your friendships. It might make you more settled than you want it to be or less. It means pulling your weight and at times pulling the weight of another. Marriage might just mean that you don't get to do everything on your bucket list. And it might cause some of the deepest pain possible. Marriage is costly. That's because marriage is more than just casual dating. It's even more than a serious, committed relationship. Marriage is a promise, a covenant of self-sacrificing love. A marriage is a solemn vow to pour out your life in sacrifice to another person. And when you've poured all you can out, you feel like you've run out of love to give, you keep giving. And when you've given all you can, you give some more. And when you don't feel like it, you give until, by God's grace, the spark of giving comes back. That's love. That's self-sacrifice. Victor and Lisa, you asked me to do your wedding. You could have asked a justice of the peace. You could have had one of your friends get one of those online ordination certificates. A lot of different options. But you chose me. So I want to give you some of the best advice that I've found, and it comes from the Bible. The Apostle Paul, one of the founders of the Christian church, writes this. Husbands, love your wives just as Christ loved the church and gave himself up for her to make her holy, cleansing her by the washing with water through the word, and to present her to himself as a radiant church without stain or wrinkle or any other blemish, but holy and blameless. In this same way, husbands ought to love their wives as their own bodies. He who loves his wife loves himself. After all, people have never hated their own bodies, but they feed and care for them just as Christ does the church, for we are members of his body. For this reason, a man will leave his father and mother and be united to his wife, and the two will become one flesh. This is a profound mystery, but I am talking about Christ and the church. Here, Paul is saying that if you want to understand marriage, you've got to take a couple steps backwards and look at the bigger picture. Marriage is actually a miniature representation of something much bigger, a little picture, a metaphor for the act of self-sacrifice. Paul says, consider God. The whole creation was his. His whole life was spread out before him. The world was actually his oyster. He didn't need anything. He had it all. If God was your friend, you might have told him to quit while he was ahead. Stay single. But Paul says, take a look at this God who chose to leave all of it behind for love. Take a look at this God who would leave it all behind to pursue the people that he loved. Take a look at this God who loved his people even when they didn't do their best or act their best, even when they didn't love him back. Paul says, take a look at this God who loved until it hurt. loved even when it made sense to quit. And then after you've looked at his life, consider this God who would love beyond all common sense and pour out his life in the person of Jesus, giving up everything to show the full extent of his love. If you want to be married, Victor and Lisa, do it like that. Look at that. If you want to know how to have the good life, do it like that. If you want to look back at from your 50th wedding anniversary and say, honey, I love you now more than the day we were married, do it like that. And that's a leap of faith. It's a real risk. But let me tell you, the payout is incredible. You live life like that, you'll have something money can't buy. You'll have someone to count on no matter what. No morning afters, no wondering if she'll still be there after the fight. No wondering what he's thinking about the relationship. You will develop a peace and an inner strength in knowing that no matter what happens, Victor is going to be there for me. No matter what happens, Lisa will be by my side. When you give your lives to one another, when you let go of your list of demands, you'll experience your capacity for love growing. You'll experience a love that can't exist at first sight. You'll begin to love loving one another. You'll find that when you give up your life for that person, you actually change on the inside too. You might actually become a better person. God uses marriage to kind of rough us up a bit, then to chisel off the rough edges, to hammer out our self-destructive tendencies, his selfishness, her impatience, his laziness, her pride. Lisa, you wanted to be more full of faith. Here's Victor at your service. Victor, you wanted more patience. Here's the chisel that God will use. Lisa. That kind of selfless, sacrificing love will make you an anchor for your entire family and a witness to the self-emptying love of God to a watching world. And it starts today with a vow, a solemn promise, but the pouring out of love continues every day for the rest of your lives. So Victor and Lisa, we are here with you today. We are for you, and we can't wait to see what the future brings. Thank you. Victor and Lisa, would you join hands? Do you, Victor, take Lisa, whose hand you now hold, as your true and lawful wife, and God helping you, will you love, cherish, honor, and protect her, devoting yourself unto her alone as long as you both shall live?
Yes, I do.
And you, Lisa, take Victor, whose hands you now hold, as your true and lawful husband, and God helping you, will you love, cherish, honor, and support him, devoting yourself to him alone as long as you both shall live?
I do.
And Victor, would you please repeat these vows after me? I, Victor, take you, Lisa.
I, Victor, take you, Lisa.
To be my wedded wife.
To be my wedded wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better or worse.
For better or worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, richer, richer.
In sickness and in health.
Sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death do us part.
Till death do us part.
According to God's holy ordinance.
According to God's holy ordinance.
And thereto I pledge you my love.
And thereto I pledge you my love.
And Lisa, would you repeat these words after me?
Yes.
I, Lisa, take you, Victor.
I, Lisa, take you, Victor.
To be my wedded husband.
To be my wedded husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer and richer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death do us part.
To that do us part.
According to God's holy ordinance.
According to God's holy ordinance.
And thereto I pledge you my love.
And thereto I pledge you my love.
At this time, the bride and groom will be reading vows that they've written for one another.
Before I started writing this, I had to, been 30 minutes of prayers. And God said I should revisit my Bible. I'll start with, in the beginning, God created the heaven and earth, and on the seventh day, he rested. You were not part of God's creation during those days. because he wanted to create you special just for me. After he rested, he now decided to create you specially for me, knowing fully well that I'm missing a piece. On Tuesday, January 12, 1993, he decided to create you specially for me. In the past 3 years, we have had an ups and downs, and we have always found our ways to overcome and stay as one. You have been my backbone and a huge factor in our kid's life. I can't thank you enough for your love and sacrifice for this family. I promise that wherever life takes us, to always make you feel like you are home. A place where you can be at ease, feel protected, and simply be your genuine self. I want you to know how honored and privileged and blessed, even with all my imperfections, you still chose me. Becoming your husband today is the greatest title and honor I will ever have. This marriage is my calling, and I will answer every time. Thank you for giving me my photocopies, Victor and Emmanuel. They are my greatest gift, and I promise to love them with all my heart and fight for them till I can't breathe no more. May you never steal, lie, or cheat. But if you must steal, then steal away my sorrows. And if you must lie, lie with me all the night of my life. And if you must cheat, then please cheat that. Because I couldn't live a day without you. I am asking to continue to be a living mother and a backbone for this family, as I will continue to go hard and provide for our journey ahead. I love you, Lisa Okorafor. No. Lisa Ifeakachi.
Yes.
I love you, sir.
Yes. Today, before God, surrounded by all your loved ones, family and friends, I choose you to be my husband. I am proud to be your wife and to join my life with yours. I vow to support you, inspire you, and love you always, for as long as we both live. I will be by your side, for better or for worse, in sickness and in health, for richer and richer. You are my one and only today and every day. I saw that you were perfect, and I loved you. But I loved you even more when I saw your imperfections. I can feel myself slowly but surely becoming me, the one I've always dreamed of. I'm the luckiest person alive today, standing here with you, facing a life with you every day. I want all of you forever. I pray that God guides me so that every day of my life I am going to be with you. I will learn to become the Proverbs 31 woman. The Lord instruct me as the one who will be your wife to submit to you as unto him. Our Father who created woman to be man's helper, it's my desire and delight to follow the scripture teaching. With all my heart, I make this pledge to you. My only prayer to you today, before God and everyone else, is that I'm going to try my best with everything I have, with the help of God, to be the best wife I can be to you and the best mother I can be to our children. I love you, husband.
Amen.
Victor, you can place the ring on Lisa's left hand and repeat these words after me. With this ring,
with this ring,
I thee wed.
I do wed.
And pledge you my love.
And pledge you my love.
Now and forever.
Now and forever.
Amen.
Amen.
And Lisa, you can place the ring on Victor's left hand and repeat these words after me. With this ring,
with this ring,
I thee wed.
I thee with.
And pledge you my love.
Pledge you my love.
Now and forever.
Now and forever.
At this time, we'd like to invite any family members to pray with Victor and Lisa.
Heavenly Father, we give you praise. We thank you this day. We honor you because you are a faithful God. Father, we thank you for this family that you have brought together today in holy matrimony. We thank you, Lord, for the journey that we've taken this far. And we know, Lord, that you are the leader and we follow. We ask, O Lord, that you bless this union. We ask, O Lord, that you continue to inspire them for great things that lies ahead of them in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. We ask, O Lord, that we will be the support that they will need every day, every moment, in the name of Jesus. We ask, O God, that you encourage us at every moment to always go on our knees and call upon your name in regard to these ones in the name of Jesus. Amen. We ask that you will bless them extraordinarily in the name of Jesus. Amen. Father, where they need wisdom, you will release it upon them. Where they need patience, you will release it upon them. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen.
By the authority vested in me as a minister of the gospel of Jesus Christ, I now pronounce you husband and wife. Victor, you may kiss your bride. It is my good pleasure to present to you for your best wishes, Mr. and Mrs. Victor and Lisa Ifeakachi.
inside. Whenever I'm broken, you make me feel whole. Whenever I'm lonely, you're there for my soul. Wherever you are, girl, that's where I call my own. Whenever you doubt it, I'll be letting you know. With you forever, you see through the storm and take me as I am. Baby, it's magic anytime that we're together. I make I just love you and hold you for my hand. Hold you for my hand, hold you for my hand, hold you for my hand.
Gentlemen, give it up for the MC. Okay. I want to thank you again for showing up, bringing in your support, bringing your laughter and your colorful appearance. I just cannot wait to get this wonderful night started. Please, give it up once again for yourselves. Give it up once again. Please. You deserve it. Thank you. So let's get this ball rolling by giving honor to who honor is due, which is the Almighty God. Without him, this is not possible, right? Who's with me right now? Who is with me right now? God deserves the best. And to do so, ladies and gentlemen, I have the honor to introduce our great pastor in the house, Pastor Aaron, ladies and gentlemen, for the opening prayer. Thank you.
Father, we're thankful for your presence. It's just so clear that you are here in this room, and we thank you. We pray, come Holy Spirit and fill this room with your joy, with your peace, with your laughter. And may this dinner just be a foretaste and a picture of a coming feast in the kingdom of God. We pray blessing upon Victor and Lisa and their marriage and their love for one another. May they have many, many years of love and devotion to one another and to you. And we just speak joy and blessing and peace over this entire reception. And we love you and give you all the glory. It's in the name of the Lord we pray. Amen.
Thank you so much, Pastor Aaron. I appreciate it. Ladies and gentlemen, we are about to get this rolling. By doing so again, we have this wonderful bridal train about to tell us that tonight is about to go down. Alright, while we are doing this, Helene and Franklin. Helen and Franklin, let's do this.
If I dance,
oh yes,
she go dance, and if I move, once you go dance, I let you dance. And if I move, first you go move.
Tandine ban, dijama mane mama
Yes, yes, yes. That's what I'm talking about. Everybody,
everybody. Time to party, oh my baby, time to party, oh shakiti, I like it when you do shako. Bakiti, I like it na niko shako.
Certifié, c'est pas ma Mr. Victor Ifeakachi, and he's wonderful, wonderful, beautiful, beautiful, anointed gift of a wife. Yes, yes. Yes, he has left the boys' level. Now he's on the men's level. Yes, it is not easy. He made the best choice of his life. Let's do this. Congratulations, guys. Ifedia. Ifedia. Yes. What are you talking? Yes. Welcome to the men's club. Welcome to the men's club. That's what I'm talking about. Mr. Cyril, I see you. I see you, the Honorable, I see you. Welcome to the club. That is how we do it. That is how we do it. We don't have no choice. Yes. When we show, then I know we show. When we appear, then know we appear. When we show off, they see us. Recognition galore. Recognition galore. That's what we're talking about. Yes, yes, yes. This is the best club. This is the best club. Yes, 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 yes. That's what I'm talking about. Mr. Big, today is your day. You have made it. You have made it. You are a man. You are a double man. Now I know who you are. You are no more a boy. You are a man. That's what I'm talking about.
And some minor speeches from the guests around tonight, but I have the pleasure to call on Mr. Vicks, Mr. Cyril, to please help us on the toast. Please, there's I think we have wines and water. Please, if you can have that close to you, so he can toast to the couple. Thank you.
Thank you, everybody, for this wonderful gathering for my daughter and my wonderful son-in-law, Victor. And I just want to use this opportunity to thank everybody for coming this evening. I know we all have busy lives, but we all are here to show our support to the new couple. And without not being taking too much time, I will, as a father, I would like to make a toast for the new wedded couple. In this toast, I just ask God for his blessing on the new wedded family. And I pray that God will be at the point of their needs. And I ask that God should guide their footsteps. And I toast that God should provide to them in every given time of their day. So tonight, from a father to my beautiful daughter and my wonderful son-in-law, I wish both of you long life, more blessings, open doors and miracles. And I ask God to always, always have a soft heart for both of you at the point of your needs. So, Heavenly Father, we thank you for this wonderful moment. And I just want to say one more time, thank you for everybody here.
Yes. Yes.
Congratulations. This is the day that you finally made it. Mercy and Nema ain't got nothing on you, Victor. You scored that spectacular goal. And today, you are letting us know. Yes, yes, yes. Ah!
Hey, Dingoma.
Congratulations.
Shimba. Bunda. Zakala. Telama. Ablo Diallo. Ifeakachi. Zala ki kozela, biso e pai bo mesana kozela. To change o, to komi na bokoko, bokolanda.
Congratulations! Yes, yes, it's all good, it's all good. Yes, 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 ah. Dogu Wakama. Oh, Dogu Wakama. Mrs. Ifeakachi, I see you. I see you. Hey, hey, hey. Ha. Ha. Hey. Pastor Dr. Emmanuel, I greet you, sir. Hey. Hey. Ah. Yes, 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 yes. Big, big congratulations. Aha. Aha. Yes, 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 yes.
You know, I'm the mother of the bra. So anything I do, that is. So please, ladies. By popular demand, I will not sit here or stand here and see the administrator sitting and not say anything. So, sir, I salute you. Yes, the administrator. Can you please come forward, sir? Thank you. Oh, here comes my beautiful D.O.N. Her Excellency. Come on, darling. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Let's go, Mama. That's the D.O.N. of Dolores Award in Park. She steers the affairs of everything. Yes. So right now, this time is our time. So we're going to do it Dolores way. And it takes so much joy to just walk and get an A.D.O.N. Woohoo! Come on, darling. Let's go. Okay. Okay, okay, okay. We have waited for this day so long. And now we yeah. If you ask, pressing former Laura, please come up. Woohoo! Yeah. Uh-huh. So if everybody, I salute you all. We got a little thing going on in Laura's. Well, we put our little $10 together and present it to anybody that will be having good thing, bad thing. We just identify with you. We just identify with you. As Guadipa, come on, Mama. That's how we do it at Laura's. You don't have to be rich. All we do, we call it $5 and just come and identify with the bra. So now to take all your time, we got our own protocol. So everybody, Mana D.O.N. and A.D.O.N. and the administrator. So we do our thing. If you can't dance, we'll bring you both on the floor to dance. So we're going to go with our African song they call, that's music. So just flow with the flow. If not, give you the mic, you can come and dance. So with all that I do, I will call the administrator to please stand forward. Thank you, sir. DJ.
I want to to carry my love away.
We play she loves.
You don't want to find my trouble. Enter bathroom, fashion. She na me you come to when your heart break. Heart break, push and she heart break. Na me you buy dinner for your mind.
DJ. All right. DJ. Give us Buka. B-U-G-A, Buka. With that song, we'll be throwing money on Lisa. Whatsoever you get, just throw it on her. It's a sound of blessing. Anything, anything. Anything. Take some dollars. Okay.
Don't sleep. Don't sleep. Wake up.
To say thank you. The Bible says little is much when God is in it. That scripture, I take it very seriously. Don't look at what is in here, but the heart that gave. Please accept this and use it wisely. Congratulations on behalf of the Laureates of Walden Park. Thank you. Oh, sorry. On behalf of the essays of the Laureates of Walden Park. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, everybody. Thank you.
Thank you, everybody. It's been an awesome evening. We all had a blast, and we will continue to have a wonderful time. You know, I was talking to somebody this evening, and I told them that each time any of my children calls me and before they hang up, I tell them I love you more. And they asked me, why do you say that? I said, yes, you know, as a father, you know, I always have to make sure that there is a reservation for forgiveness even when nothing has ever happened. You know, so with that being said, I and my wife and the entire family has single-handedly took care of Lisa, and she grew to the beautiful woman she is today. And, you know, then she met a wonderful husband, Victor. And I think he's, everybody will agree with me that it's time for me to sign off. Knowing that Victor will pick up from where we left. So what that means is that both of you, you know, like the pastor mentioned earlier, that both of you need to find, each time things are very hard for two of you, you need to tap into where the love started from. I have your mother here, which is my beautiful wife. Every marriage has ups and downs. Thank you. But as a father to a daughter, my only advice here is you never go to bed angry with your husband without not making peace. And the same thing applies to Victor. It's just a very simple, common way of life. You don't want to have a carryover the next morning. Whatever happens today ends today, because there is a beautiful day tomorrow. So with all the blessings that your grandmother, grandfathers has given to me, I will bless this marriage, and I am the happiest man on earth now. I am so happy that our God, who said he is gonna make a way where there is no way, has made a way. And we all need to thank these two wonderful souls. It has not been easy, but the God has always been with them. So from a father to my two beautiful children, I bless you. I ask God to continue to guide you. I ask God to continue to listen and open doors when you call. I ask that he will not turn his back on you guys. And I pray that from today and moving forward, my beautiful grandchildren will be blessed. Whatever your hands lays on will be blessed. He said, I will bless you in the land that you never even believed that he existed. As most of you will testify, I was born in Africa. We all was born in Africa. But God has blessed us in this great nation. And my prayer this evening is that whatever blessings that comes from this, our United States of America, should follow you guys all your way. Again, thank you everybody for showing up this evening. I can never thank you guys enough. This is the best day of my life. Thank you. Je savais chanter un peu, j'ai fait ma passe au pouvoir.
je chante à la radio. En tout à Israël, tu le cas où à percer. Oh. Attends, je vais partir le couper. Oh. Mais on dit premier Gaou n'est pas Gaou. C'est deuxième Gaou qui est Nyatao. Deuxième Gaou qui est Nyatao. Tu marches matin et coco, on frappe à ma porte. À ma grande surprise, oh, c'est la go, en tout je vois. Oh. Assemblage est dit, oh, y a longtemps, c'est plus revu. Oh. Elle veut me mentir, oh, elle dit chérie, j'avais voyagé. Oh. Je suis de retour, oh, je t'appartiens. Oh. Prends-moi cadeau.
Hallelujah. First of all, I want to thank everyone that made it possible to this place and all that have been patient till this moment. Thank you so much. Thank you to the wonderful church that's been shepherding Victor. Please a round of applause for them. What a wonderful people. We appreciate you being here, you know, adapting with our African time. Okay, so we appreciate you so much. Victor is my nephew, so I'm stepping in as a dad for him tonight. The mom is my elder sister. I grew up carrying this wonderful gentleman in my mind. Where is Miracle? I don't know. He probably might be somewhere busy. Okay, right there in the back. You know, growing up as a young man, they were my biggest burden. But I give God all the glory today for where God has brought them. And seeing this wonderful day come into reality, I want to say congratulations to Mr. and Mrs. Ifeakachi. Can we put our hands together for them? I had an extensive conversation with your dad this morning and your mom. And throughout the week, I've been speaking with barely every member of the family. And that has changed a little bit my composure this evening. And I want you to know that your family love you so much, Victor. And I want you to know that you come from a very, very proud, ancient Inachoken kingdom, of which I'm representing tonight with my attire. Can you just put your hands together for me? Hallelujah. And we are very cultural people and very decent people. And I want you to carry that decency wherever you're going. I want you to represent us well with the Okorocha family. I want you to know that it is not the first, neither will it be the last. My wife is a Sierra Leonean. Can we put our hands together for First Lady Florence Ina? So intermarriage has been part of us, and we've done it with class and with decency. And yours will not be an exception, in Jesus' name. My advice to you is to always love your wife, because that is one thing that the Bible said. It said, love your wife as Christ loved the church and died for it. That means your love must go beyond mistakes. Your love for your wife must be such that you're willing to give up everything for her. In the history of this family, we do not entertain divorce, and you know that very well. And let me just remind you, every space you think you can keep for yourself as a divorcee is not available in the entire family. So this is a journey that you will take for the rest of your life. I'm standing here celebrating 25 years of my marriage. Can we just put our hands together again for that lovely woman? That 25 years is not 25 days. It takes courage to stay married. Many has performed what we just see tonight, and it didn't last the next 1 month. But yours will last for everlasting, in the name of Jesus. I want to also advise you that you don't forget where you are coming from. Because the last time I checked, GPS is from where you're coming to where you're going. When you lose where you're coming from, you see what we call rerouting. And I pray you will not have any rerouting in the name of Jesus. Lisa will be by your side when you will turn 100. Lisa will be by your side when you turn 150. As a matter of fact, she is an Abreba woman. And we welcome you with all our arms open, Lisa. You do not have anything to be afraid of. There are so many foreigners in this family, and they are really, really adapting very well. So Victor, love your wife. Love your wife. There is no limit in loving. And I encourage you, as you were raised as a child that have the fear of God. I'm saying this very emotional because your dad was supposed to be here. When he got married to my elder sister, we do not go to church. If I'm a pastor today, I bring that credit back to your father because he did everything beyond what any other man can do to make sure that we knew God. And it has become a legacy in this family. And standing here looking at you, I can remember all his words this morning. But all I can leave with you in this platform that I'm standing is that love your wife. Let nothing come between both of you, including me. Let us not come between both of you. And congratulations once again. Let's put our hands together for the best couple of tonight, Mr. and Mrs. Victor Ifeakachi. Thank you so much, Mr. MC.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you, sir. And I believe Pastor Emmanuel will definitely take the message back to his kingdom. For what he has witnessed tonight, I think before he even gets there, the kingdom is already at peace and they're already in happiness because this is destined to happen. Forever love. Divorce will never be anybody that has married here. Divorce will never be an option. In Jesus' name. Thank you very much. So as we move on, we have to do what we do best. Mrs. Lawrence, if you can step up to the podium. Mr. Victor, newly married man, from the level of boys to men. He's in the club right now. The men's club. Mother and son man. Thank you. Thank you.
I'm gonna go to Down. ukulana kilondolose zuhambena dauyami alikulana buso wami ukulana kilondolose
today. I've known Lisa for 5 years. We started as LPN and then here we are today. I want to say I thank you guys for coming. All I can say is I've never been married before. But all I can say is I wish you all the best. I know I've heard that marriage is tough, but I pray and I hope that God will protect them and guide them. Whatever challenges they go through, I pray that God will see them through it and then bless them. Thank you.
Thank you guys for coming. My name is Precious and I'm the best man. And it's funny how time flies. Been here 5 years since I met Victor, and when I met him, he was a very ambitious young guy. He was always about, you know, making a name for himself, making things happen. And after 2 years, he met Lisa, and it's everything changed in just a matter of weeks. I'm telling you, when you meet the right person, things take a turn for the best in a quick time. I'm telling you, and I'm just grateful for how Lisa, helped him grow. Over the last few years, he's become a better man. He's more ambitious. He's thinking about the right things. And I think, she's not here, but I want to say thank you, Lisa. And I'm even more excited for the man you're going to help him become in the next few years. So to the new bride and groom, congrats to the Ifeakachi. Thank you guys for coming.
I think my wife should go first.
Good evening. I have 5 pages. Do I have some time to read them? They're blank. They're all blank. But firstly, I want to thank God Almighty that ordained this marvelous day and this marvelous occasion. We are rejoicing in His grace, and we are so grateful that Victor and Lisa have come together and brought us all together as well to fellowship with them. Secondly, I want to thank God Almighty for bringing Lisa, Victor, Emmanuel, and Junior in our lives. And just wanted to thank them for honoring us to be part of this celebration with them. So we wish them the best. I'll always be here, phone call away. She calls me Big Sis, so she can always call anytime. I know she's not here, but I know she'll hear this later. All right. Love you, Victor and Lisa. Thank you.
Wonderful. I was hoping they're here so I can speak to them. Hopefully it's recorded. I'm thankful to God Almighty that a few months ago, Victor and Lisa walked into our lives. They showed up to our church. And I'm thankful to God. There's a few things I began to speak to them because I recognized that the struggles they were going through are exactly the struggles me and my wife went through 11 years ago. The message I began to speak to you, Victor and Lisa, I began to speak to you about the love of God, right? 1 John 3, verse 16 says, "By this we know love, because he laid his life for us. Therefore, we ought to lay our lives for our brethren," right? So the love of God is a he. Amen. The love of God is a he. Then Romans 5:5 says to us that hope in God will not disappoint us. Why? Because the love of God has been poured into our hearts by the Holy Spirit who was given to us. So this love, who's a he, can be poured into your heart by the Holy Spirit. Right. Then Lisa, there's a scripture I made you read over and over, and that's 1 Corinthians 13, verse 4 to 7. It says, the love of God is long-suffering. He endures long. He's patient. He keeps no record of wrongs. He thinks the best of everyone and everything. And this love endures all things. Amen. So the love of God is not natural. Natural love comes to an end. Natural love will fall apart. It reaches an end, a breaking point, right? But if you're born again, you've got something else that will help you, right? Which is the love of God that has entered into you when you were born again, right? The man that's not born again does not have this kind of love. But you and Lisa have this kind of love. Therefore, you can be long-suffering. You can live a life of not keeping grudges, right? You can endure anything and everything, right? So that's the message that I'll continue to speak to both of you in the years to come. That's all. Thank you.
Thank you so much, brother. Thank you so much. Word. That is impactful. That is really impactful. God bless you. God bless you. I know you took heed on that, Mr. Vic. That is really, really very impactful. I'm going to open the floor. I'm going to open the floor for anybody to have a brief speech, advice, words of wisdom, please. Indicate by raising your hand. I will give you the mic to say one or two words. I know from the pastoral perspective, I'll give again our pastor in the house to say one or two words to the couple. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Congratulations again, Mr. Victor Ifeakachi, and to your lovely wife. And thank you very much for inviting us here to join in this beautiful celebration of love. We're happy for you that you found your soulmate, your life companion. And you've heard many, many words of advice, many prayers, and many wise counsel. And I believe that you will put this into practice as you journey on. Love is stronger than death. And love covers a multitude of sins. And love conquers everything. Many waters, they say, cannot quench love. And we're happy for you that you have found love. And love is forever because God is love and God is eternal. And so we pray your love will be forever. Amen.
Thank you, thank you, thank you. And we have our brother here to say a word of wisdom as well.
Victor, it has been a pleasure to meet you and know you, my friend. On behalf of all of us that came here from church, we really love you and Lisa, and it's just been an honor to be invited and be among your family and friends here. And I think I met you several months ago, Victor, and I could right away see the man of God you are and how much you love the Lord, your wife, and your kids, and I think it's something we can all aspire to. So just thank you for being you, Victor, and I'm excited to grow in friendship with you more. To the Ifeakachi.
Thank you. Thank you, sir. Thank you so much. That is something to take home with. Mr. Clifford. Thank you.
Victor and Lisa, on behalf of the family, I just want to give you advice that our father, your grandfather used to say. He said, be like an egg, you know. Whether you boil an egg or fry an egg, it always has yolk and egg white. We had testimonies from both families that you guys have been good people. Now you're living together. Always remember, be an egg. Be good. Always keep God at the center of your life. The testimonies of your parents' marriage, and to testify that if God is the center and the one driving the marriage, you'll reach your destiny. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Clifford. Thank you, thank you, thank you. I will take one more. One more words to the couple. Any, raise your hand. Okay. Oh, Mr. Tony. Tony the man.
Victor. I just met you some time ago, before you guys did your traditional marriage. And I fell in love with you. I find out that you are a very wonderful guy. And my advice to you is to love your wife. Respect your wife. And, you know, do the best you can and leave the rest to God. Yeah, that's my advice to you. Thank you.
Follow my lead. I found a girl, beautiful and sweet. Well, I never knew you were the someone waiting for me. 'Cause we were just kids when we fell in love, not knowing what it was. I will not give you up this time. All I own, and in your eyes, you're holding mine. Baby, I'm dancing in the dark with you between my arms, barefoot on the grass, listening to our favorite song. When you said you looked a mess, I whispered underneath my breath, but you heard it, darling, you look perfect tonight. Well, I found a woman stronger than anyone I know. She shares my dreams. I hope that someday I'll share her home. I found a love to carry more than just my secrets, to carry love, to carry children of our own.
The stars in the sky, she's worth more than diamond.
Okay.
She is worth more than silver. Special kind of woman. Oh yeah. Imamaya wawaya.
So at the count of Jesus, ladies and gentlemen, let's go with the J, E, S, U, S. Come on, let's put our hands together for them. All right, that's beautiful. And we are going to do one more thing again. We want to see how Victor is going to take care of Lisa. How many of us want to see that? If you want to see that, let me hear your voice. And we also want to see how Lisa is going to be taking care of this handsome gentleman. All right, so Victor, can we get a knife, please, for them? And probably a little plate. All right, so let's see how Lisa does that. Wow, in a Zimbabwe way, okay. Wow. Okay. Hey. Somebody shout hallelujah. So shall it be. I say so shall it be. All right, Victor. Show yourself. Victor is looking for something. Okay. Wow, this this beats Victor's expectation. Okay. Well, let's see what Victor is going to do. The sweetness of that cake got him confused. Okay. Wow. He's going to do something else in the Nigerian way. Oh, my God. Wow. Wow, that's beautiful. That's beautiful. That's Ifeakachi for you. Hey. Are we following? Is everyone following? All right. Come on, a round of applause for them, please.
I'm not gonna play with you. I don't know them.
Check up.
If you check up, you go no say na confirm. Oh yeah, chichi. Shoba don't you pelu kiki.
Yeah, no confirm.
Spencer, I bought more uchi wai.
Your Spencer, la la.
I like it sunny, froze. I be what if I move you. Oh yeah, popo li. I'm willing, woman, be what you
want. You got a eyes on my neck. Eyes on my neck.
Yeah.
George Weya, Waka Waka, l'homme de tous les dossiers, Ayaoune, Rafa.
One more try, I go tire. I'm a shaman, Americana. Just go back from Atlanta. Small toast thing, you dey holla. You dey bad person with saliva. Habba, mama, me are ready to spend it in rubber. So much green, I'm a farmer. Come and harvest the cassava. Tibama told you a dada. Say you go reduce the drama. Say you no go leave me for yawa. Say you go meet my mama.